Inside this church in the heart of Montreal's Little Italy lies the story of one man caught up in a historical wrong the federal government wants to make right.
Look at the expressions or the individuals. See, that's one of his strengths over here.
Roger Bocini Ninkeri is the step-grandson of the building's architect, Guido Ninkeri, a celebrated artist in his day, but eventually vilified for this, a fresco he created in the 1930s that included fascist Italian dictator Benito Mussolini.
When Guido saw that they wanted to put Mussolini in it, he completely said no. The wardens, let's say, pushing, look, if you don't do it, we'll tear up the contract.
He wouldn't get paid.
Yeah, that's it, you had it, okay? So he was forced to do it.
Back in 1940, authorities considered the painting proof that Ninkeri was a fascist. Italy had just joined the Second World War on the side of Nazi Germany, and Ottawa declared 31,000 Italian Canadians enemy aliens. Ninkeri was among 600 detained, suspected of being traitors.
I look at the record at the end and see no convictions.
Now the federal government is trying to make amends with a formal apology for the treatment of Italian Canadians back then, a gesture championed by this cabinet minister.
I look at it from the perspective of a minister of justice, and I, as the first Italian-Canadian minister of justice, and I'm proud and a bit overwhelmed emotionally.
But this historian is worried Ottawa is rewriting history.
They were interned because the government had some evidence. Now, how serious this evidence was is an issue to be determined, but had evidence that these people had links with the Italian fascist party.
When I look at it, there's so much symbolism, especially
in Ninkeri's case. Original sketches of the fresco without Mussolini led to his release, but the impact was long-lasting.
He lost a lot of money, and also not only money, but also to his reputation. Oh, you're a fascist, and he was not a fascist whatsoever.
Now, 81 years later, Ottawa's apology is public redemption for Ninkeri. And finally, closure for his family. Olivia Stefanovic, CBC News, Ottawa.